Now, after seeing this little guy, many people requested a Xenaph Science plush. And with the power of the Combruta's potiony goodness, we can make that happen. We just grab this, give it a throw, and hyperfluffination of the incutilossical molecular axis through a real olysis reaction of the plushy wave has occurred. Or in other words, he got cute. Hello, hello, and welcome back to another episode here on the Hermitcraft server with the Xenaph. And yes, it is completely true. You could get your hands on a little Xenaph Science plush of your own if you head on over to xenaph.com/plush or check the link in the description down below. You can check it out. Make sure you do soon because they are only available for a very limited time. So if you want one, go check them out now. They're very, very cute. They have detachable science goggles. It's the cutest thing in the world ever. But yeah, we are here in the beautiful Combruta 2.0, which we completed last episode, and this machine, I knew it would be. Oh my goodness me, this has been my most favourite project I have ever done, and lots of people seem to agree as well. It's, it's gone down very well, let's say the least. So, very, very proud of this one. If you missed any of the making of, that was what we worked on over the last few episodes, but it is done now, and we can just kind of, well, I should probably turn it off, actually. I should turn it off here, but we can leave this room knowing that we have completed something very, very special that we should be proud of. And yes, this does look like a big glass moustache. I just wanted Mumbo to feel happy when he came over to the base before, but finishing up that has really got finishing stuff into my blood. Whatever that is, I might have to do some science to find out what chemical makes you want to finish things up, because yeah, I've got a real feeling. Where am I going? A real feeling to finish up some projects out here, i.e. the big old villager breeder tower. That is going to be done today from start to finish. From egg, villagers aren't in eggs, I should know this, from baby parents all the way down, blah, 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 all the way down to being able to extort them for as much money as we like in a lovely little test tube down here. We shall be able to get our villagers, and that whole project will be complete from start to finish today when we finish up the top floor. But this, we have a visitor to deal with. Hello? I'm assuming this is the back of your face. It's like a creeper Frankenstein thing. There's a sign over here. Oh my goodness, hello, you have a nose. This Frankenstein is courtesy of Gem and Pearl. Yes, we have been Halloween visited by the wonderful Gem and Pearl, and they've given us this guy. Wow, I was not expecting that eye to be facing up that way. What are you again? A Frankenstein monster. Okay, so your name, I'm going to call you Frank for sure. But you know, this is a serious laboratory. We can't be having things like this, big Halloween pranks just sitting around the place. This is not professional. There we go. Much better. Safety spectacles in place. This is a lab, of course. And, you know, even the little plush has to have safety specs. So why not our brand new friend with a very interesting vegetation-y nose? At least that's what I hope it is. Maybe it's just a bit of last night's dinner. Anyway, let's work on the villager tower. So into the top floor we go, if I can successfully. That was a success. I managed to hit both sides of the door, but I'm in, and that was all I care about. We are successfully at the top floor now. Every floor below us has got full functionality in all of its glory, but this top one, whilst technically being functional, this is just one of those little impulse villager breeders here. You just chuck the carrots, and maybe we can get one going now. Let's see. I'm sorry, I'm such a bad throw. Yeah, if we throw them in, they should kind of fling them around to each other. If they even ate them. Did they even eat them? This is the trouble with this farm, right? You kind of got to either... Oh, they did get them. And they're now going to breed and plop out a little baby, which is so small, he'll fit down the side of that fence post there. But we want to kind of revolutionize this up a little bit, science it up, and really break this down into its core components. I think this is a bit too simple. Impulse. Whoa, there he goes. We need to work out exactly what happens at every single stage. And I now they're both looking at me. I realize this is a breeder. So, you know, we got to have a mummy and a daddy, and they have to love each other very much. And then some science stuff happens, and then a baby plops out. So yeah, we will try and do this with as much grace and care as we possibly can. But for now, we can rip this place to shreds. Get out of there, parents! Right, so objective number one is going to be keeping the two parents slightly further apart. In the previous design, they are pretty much smushed together, which, you know, I guess has some advantages, but also some disadvantages. So if we put the two of them in these little tubes like this, and then we get something like this on top. Oh, I kind of need to place it where the torch is, don't I? If we put an upside down trapdoor there, that would mean we could actually get rid of all of this still, or we could even replace these with trapdoors as well. We could really minimize this down using the same trick. Excuse me, get off. Using the same trick as we used down in the test tubes of trapdoors, because these villagers are exactly 2 blocks high, which means as long as they have something over their head like so, I can stand in here and, you know, walk out and leave, but they can't. Look, will you go in there just to prove my point for me? Please, please, get in there. Oh, this is perfect. Yes, okay, so you're trapped. So as long as we have you one side and the same for the other one, that means we can get rid of this fence post. You cannot get out there, but a baby, as long as they're slightly shorter than you, which I think they normally are, otherwise that'll be a pretty tricky birth, will just literally slide right out through this massive opening and down the hole there. And I'm pretty sure we might have to do some science. Where are you? That you two can still breed across a one gap block. You know, you can kind of do it like social distance breeding. And it's probably a good, safe idea to pop the beds back down again and see if we start getting love hearts. Those green little sparkles, that is good. That means they found a bed. You should still have some carrots in you as well. So, yeah, we'll just wait now. Wait until the miracle of birth takes place. Maybe we give you a little top up and you a little top up as well. And we've moved the beds so that they can't climb in them at night. I think how it works is the baby needs to be able to have access to the bed. Not these two, not the parents. They don't need any access at all. So, oh, love hearts, it can still all go wrong here. It's happened before, but technically a little baby might happen. Now, what's going to happen if it does work is they will be born at the feet of one of the parents. Kind of inside, there we go. It's still, there's an arm. I see an arm. But yeah, as you saw, you just escaped completely. So this is kind of no good either. We want it to always fall down the hole here. So I'm thinking maybe we provide a little bit of water features, a little bit of push power. So boom. Oh no, it's dribbled down the hole. That's fine though. It's kind of showing what I mean. This guy's stuck. The water current is too strong and it's just pushing your big flat forehead right into the edge of that lane there. So if we do that to both sides, boom, 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 and give you... No! Oh, no! Excuse me, please. Thank you. Go in the hole, thanks, please. For science, right? Oh, no, please. Please! Okay, maybe we pick the water up real quick. Boom. And then shove you under. Aha! There. Now you are successfully trapped. And even though you could walk out this way, you don't even need this anymore. You can't do it. Look, you're trying to, but you're just too weak in the legs. You skipped leg day. So there's the problem. And that means when the baby is born at the very, very feet of either parent, all that's going to happen is it's going to get washed into the middle here. We probably want to add something like so. I kind of want to make that an open trap door. That should still give the baby plenty of room to fall down. I guess we could go back to our fence. Like we had previous, but no, an open trap door should do the trick, like so, and then yeah, the baby should just fall straight out, and even though you're stronger, you have a lot more leg power going on, I know, you're showing off right now, aren't you, it should just be born, and bloop bloop, just straight away, before it even kind of knows where it's at, its legs won't even have time to kick in, and it should fall down the hole, so that is how we're going to be dealing with that situation. Now, I'm a man with a very limited number of carrots, as you can see, but all it takes to make a baby is 12 carrots for mummy and 12 carrots for daddy. So if we split that up into something like so, that's all it takes. That's like the bare minimum. That is what gets used up when a baby is born. So if we could kind of drain all the carrots from both of you and then just give you 12 and you 12, that's 24 carrots. 24 carat gold idea, this one. That means we can guarantee one baby and one baby alone is made whenever we like. So at the press of a button, 12 carrots, 12 carrots. And you can see we've already got an item stream, a water stream here, ready to deliver those carrots as well. So if we grab our 12, I think the problem is going to happen. Like if we throw this in, you're not quick enough. It just went through your ankles. Why didn't you hoover up the carrots and pick them up? Okay, so we're going to have to deal with that another problem, but we've already solved it. Yes, that is what science is all about. Already solving problems before they even become problems, which is very paradoxical, but that is what I have done here by this little bit of trapdoor right there. If we throw these carrots, or only 12, please, only 12. If we throw them down this edge, boom, they actually get stopped by the trapdoor and just hang out there and don't fall all the way down. So we just want to make sure that this water aligns all the items that's in it onto this left-hand side, and this one it would obviously be on the right hand side, and we can guarantee carrot delivery. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 carrots delivered successfully, but very unsuccessfully, because I had to do it manually, and I don't want to have to do it manually. I want all of my counting done by robots. Oh, they're even throwing stuff around now. Why can't you guys spread them out carefully? Just don't be so greedy. Oh, they're going to make a baby. Don't be greedy. Just take 12 from each thing instead of having to be so forced it. But okay, let's check the water stream is going to successfully pop the baby straight out and down the hole. Wow, it caught some air. Yeah, hi there. Hi, little baby. You're just going to stay trapped down there for a while. So that works nicely, but we want to replace our lever, of course, with something that is going to count things out. A little redstone circuit, very much like this one here. This is my idea that I've had, right? So this is just the normal little pulse extender, the usual thing. It just goes round and round, and each time it goes round, because of these two dust here, it loses one power. So this this little dust here is going from 15, when we first put it on, 15, and then it's going like 14, 13, 12, blah, 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 all the way down until eventually the whole thing dies out. Standard stuff. But if we trap a little dropper on the end of this and observe this light, boom, like so, then every time this changes from 15 to 14, bam, it sends a tick out. 14 to 13, bam, again. Or that's exactly what I'm hoping. So let's put our own carrots on the line here. I'm surprised I'm not having little babies pop out my butt every 5 seconds with the amount of carrots I eat. But anyway, okay, so we pop this on, boom, one. A whole load of I can't even count how many carrots. Okay, we're going to need to be a lot more scientific, a lot more precise about this. Let's put them all in, and we press the button, and we see exactly how many carrots we get back. Oh! Okay, we get 15. We get 3 too many. So I believe if we reduce this down, instead of it going all the way up to the maximum power of 15, we move this away a little bit like so. If we grab this, maybe we move it there. So, instead of getting 15 carrots, that should give us 14 carrots. That should give us 13 carrots, so to speak. Let's pop them all back. Push the little button. Stand up. Up. And 13 carrots. I wanted 12. Why did I purposely? I don't know. If we do this, though, it technically made sense. It worked. Like so. That should give us one less carrot. Please, please, please. Carrot, no, come back. Uh-oh. 11 and 12. Perfect. I'm a genius. I'll never have to struggle manually counting to 12 again. Ah, oh, and even more geniusly, I have managed to squeeze it all in down here, down below. It's a little bit tight, but it works. If we pop back out, you'll see, yeah, it's all kind of hidden. This button here, we just give this a little whack, and we get the 12 ticks from either side. I had to put the same one on either side. You could see there's the stuff over that side, and it's just mirrored over there too. This all works quite nicely. I think where the babies drop down, down this hole, obviously they'll land here, but the actual hole that we want to put them through is right here. I kind of shifted things over a little bit, so we're going to need to get another little water stream down here that just pushes the babies off the edge. But I kind of want to do that with another trapdoor flapped down like so. No, give me the lever, like that. But the water's not really going to flow then, so I think we need to extend the water out one extra block this way, like so. And then when we plop the water down, oh, I put it in a half slab. That could be really bad news. Did we just flood the world? I think we just flooded the entire world downstairs. No, please. It's fine. It's fine. Sploosh this down correctly. And then it's just a matter of getting a chest here that we can wiggle one to this side and one to this side with some hopper chains. Where are my hoppers? Right there. Okay, so can we do this nice and tightly? I kind of want to replace the glass, just like that, and then this one here. Oh, I've got to be in the right position to do this, though, nice and quick. We break a place, very, very good, and then if we pull out of this side and maybe go wiggle, 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 and finally down under here like that, it should mean that any carrots we put in here, as long as we put in more than one, yeah, it takes two at a time, and it should be splitting them evenly. Get out of there, glass. It should split them evenly between the two as well. So whenever we got spare carrots, we throw them in this chest just like so, and we'll get them split relatively evenly, which is very, very nice. So we can cover up most of this floor again. Not with hoppers, though. Come on, guys. But functionally, that is basically it complete. At least I hope so anyway. I've not really given it a full test yet. But yeah, all the carrots are in. We need to give this thing a little bit of a lick of paint. That's kind of a problem that you can't really hit the button when you get close to it. I guess this glass block here technically isn't really needed. The baby should fall straight down still, but maybe we should put some glass up on this layer here. We're going to have to decorate the whole thing, maybe put some more trapdoors over the whole top bit. I quite like these little side columns, being able to see the carrots float up there. Obviously, we've got no soul sand down there to make them whiz up, but if anything, that's better as well, because they'll just slowly go up the water sources we've got up there. You've got to have water sources still. They'll just slowly float on up. I guess we can see. We could give it a test. Are you ready to make a baby, folks? Let's do it. Let's hit the button. Watch the carrots flow. All 12 of them either side. Oh, that's really nice. It's about to be nighttime, though, which obviously, yeah, that's going to prevent you from making babies. It's a daytime thing. Ocaralis slept. Okay, that's all good. Okay, baby making commence now. You, my friend, you've got about 5 babies worth of carrots in you. You should have only had 12, though. So, yes, there's the love hearts. Fantastic. Plop out that baby, and we'll watch it fall straight down the hole. I guess I can't really put a block here either, because that will block the button. That's the only problem with having the button kind of at the back there. Oh, unhappy. Unhappiness. I figured it out. There was only 2 beds back here. We got to plop down some extra beds as well. I got rid of those at one point when I was doing the redstone. You might need more carrots. You probably used some of them up. Yeah, let's just give you some more. Oh no, I'm going to end up with about 20 babies here. I can't be doing 20 baby villagers all at once. And there's the baby. Wah, straight down and straight down the hole he goes. Now he should be down here in the next floor, spinning around. Oh, we must have had a launch failure. Get out of there. Oja. Okay, very, very good. Excellent. And he will now wait here until he grows up big and strong, I think. And then that completes the rest of the tower, folks. We have a fully working, baby-making, villager-captivating tower on our hands. Don't watch this bit. This bit's not going in the montage. Okay, we can't. I hadn't thought of a way of getting them out of this bit yet. So just don't watch. Don't. Oh, okay. Ow. Ow. In we go. In we go. Excuse me, door. Thank you. Oh, I've got to press both. Oh, no. Oh, this is never going to happen. And we shall be putting you in this little one right over here. Let's get the composter in. And what's the best way of doing this? I've still not figured it out. I think we just wait. Until eventually you choose your fate. No, that's not your fate. Oh my goodness, I've just been waiting here for like 3 minutes and he finally did it. He walked in. Okay. Good, you're nice and stuck now. Another weird thing about him, his later prices over here, like they've all gone back up again. I'm not entirely sure what's going on. But you got cured plenty of times. You got cured your full five. All of you have still got nice cheap prices, but we might need to give you one final top up to remember something. I don't know, but you got some good carrots and potatoes going on. You also buy the melons, and of course, you sell the golden carrots as well. Everything we kind of want from you. Plenty more villagers to come, though, and of course, we now have the entire start-to-finish sequence in our entire tower all the way up here. We can take a little look at it from a nice distance. It's getting nice and full. We need to, like, plug up some holes in the windows and make some proper entrances and that, but I would say that this project is... it's done. It's completely done. Look at those two lovebirds over there. Yeah, we have finished the project and I could not be happier. That is all we have time for today, folks. Thank you so, so very much for watching. Remember, zf.com/plush if you want to check out the brand new science plushie and get your hands on one of those. Remember, the limited edition. A massive, massive thank you, as always, to my wonderful, beautiful, gorgeous patrons whose names are all over the screen. These people have helped to support me and support episodes just like this. Thank you, thank you, thank you. But until... the next episode, which is going to be a chamber episode, by the way, who's it going to be? A good. A bye.